In this session, we'll be talking about Venn screen and reflections and USAS Web's vendor area and some vendor reports. In USA screen, Venn screen, the window displays the master vendor file by vendor. This program allows you to search for a vendor, add a new vendor, update an existing vendor, delete an existing vendor. And when you're creating a vendor, you will use the add option of the program. A vendor number is required for every vendor used in USAS. In addition to the vendor number, these files also include the names, addresses, phone numbers, and year-to-date amounts paid to each vendor, and other vendor tax-related information. The vendor information contained within the vendor master file is used when creating purchase orders, requisitions, checks, when receiving in money, reports, and tax forms like 1099s. So here's a look at Venn screen, and like I said, you can use the function keys to find, add, delete, or modify a vendor. You will see the vendor address information at the top that includes the name, the address, city, state, zip, and telephone numbers. Then the 1099 information. This contains the type of vendor. So is this a, this one is a one, a non-employee compensation, two is for rents, three for other income, and so on. The ID number, this is the vendor ID number. This is a tax ID number that is either their Social Security number or their EIN number. And just a side note, this tax ID number will show as X's rather than the numeric values if the user has read-only or requisition-only privileges. This is the type. What type of ID number is this? Is this an SSN or EIN? So the code here is S or E. And Venn screen is the only screen to enter this type of ID code. Over here is the check address information. This is where you will enter a payment address. If the payment is sent to a different vendor name or location, than the purchasing information, as is in my example here. The last section is the year-to-date totals. These are the totals paid to the vendor. Here's a look at what the vendor record looks like in USAS Web, and just like in Reflections, you can add, modify, or search and delete a vendor. At the top of the screen, you can choose to modify the vendor record. After you click Modify, you will update the record accordingly and then click Accept to save the changes. The next option here is the Delete button. It's not recommended to delete old vendors since this might destroy an audit trail. And if a vendor number is reused, then reports from prior fiscal years will not match current vendor information. We recommend changing the status from active to inactive. If you choose to delete a vendor, it's important that you run DelVen program prior to deleting a vendor. As another side note, read-only users, these would be users with read-only privileges, may not be able to add or update vendors, and this is controlled by a setting in the user's USAS security profile. One other trick I want to show you when you are in a vendor query is you can click on this little plus icon here. So this is what the first screen would look like in vendor query. And what happens is when you click on this plus icon, this box will expand and give you more search options. You can use a wild card in any of these fields that are marked here with a red star to help you with your search options. So in my example here, I want to search for a towing company, but I can't remember the vendor name. So I type in the word towing with a wild card on either side. And I know that it's located in the city of Sample. And so if I go ahead and I activate my search, it brings up Rusty's Towing Services in Sample City. When you're using these advanced search options, you might have to change the display to more than 50 vendors. So you change this maximum vendors displayed to as many as 250 results. That's the maximum number allowed. Also within USAS Web Vendors, vendor numbers are denoted by these digits, this range of digits, 900000 through 999999. These are reserved for memo vendors. Memo checks may be written to a vendor with a vendor number between that range. And obviously, there is no printed check form generated because the money is transferred electronically. The last thing I want to cover in this section is reports. So this first report is called Vendors. This is a listing of all active vendors, inactive vendors, or a listing of both active and inactive. Now this report option gives you multiple sort options because you have the ability to sort by vendor name, vendor number, vendor category, last active date, range of vendors by number, and names that begin with a specified character. The next one is VendList, which is a similar listing of active and inactive vendors, but the sort options are limited to vendor name and number sort. The next one is VendorOne. This is a full vendor report that generates a list of all vendors. VendorTwo generates a listing of all vendors whose fiscal year-to-date total exceeds a given threshold. The next report is VendSSN. This is option 5 in vendor reports, and it lists vendors who exceed a calendar year-to-date threshold. VendSSN is a good report to run so that you can review any vendors that should get a 1099 if their calendar year-to-date threshold was at least $599.99 or more. And lastly, VendHire is a listing of all the USAS vendors with payments of at least $2,500 for the calendar year and with the new hire flag set to yes, indicating that they need to be reported.